tonight. Be blessed, O Lord, tonight. Amen. Bless the Lord. We say welcome, 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 welcome to Power Hour Prophetic Encounter. Amen. With your host, Prophet Moses, and myself, Joy Solomon, we thank you. Dr. Hampton has a word, hallelujah, that he needs to release the people. Amen. This New Year's month. Amen. So we bless the Lord for Dr. Eva Hampton out of Jacksonville, Florida. Amen. She comes to you from Jacksonville, Florida, from Answer the Call Outreach Ministry at com. Amen. Answer the Call Outreach Ministry. Amen. Amen. Mighty work there. Amen. Has a school as well as the church. Amen. So she's moving. She's building. Amen. So you know God is with her. Amen. If she's building, God with her. Amen. Expanding. Hallelujah. Yes. For the soldiers are getting ready to run into the church. Amen. We thank God for this powerful woman of God who holds all the five gifts. Amen. And can use them accurately. Hallelujah. So without further ado, she's been on the line before. We released a 90-day Psalm 23, and we still walking in that. We still in the 90-day period. Amen.
Amen.
The manifestation is making its way. Amen. So we bless the Lord for that message. It is out there on YouTube for those who missed it. Amen. A powerful word. But at this time, I'm going to release the line to Dr. Eva Hampton out of Jacksonville. Dr. Hampton, at this time, you have charge of this line. Bless you.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you all for being on the line tonight. We don't take this lightly and appreciate you in inviting us to be a participant, a partaker of God's move, even as he's doing it through the prophetic prayer line. And I think that this is definitely timing for what God is doing in this season, because we need a prophet in our life, and we need to be directly connected to the mouth of God. We don't need to guess what God is saying now. We don't need to ponder or wonder what God is saying, but we need to be clearly tuned in to what the Lord is saying in this hour. And I had posted when getting closer to the time to come on that if you would send me your name, I would just release myself to the mind of God. And if God has a word for you tonight, I'm going to take the time to do that. I've just been in that vein. I am a prophet from my mother's womb, but I try not to get people where they are operating in itching ears, because this is the season you're going to have to do something with the prophetic word that you're going to get. You're going to have to walk that word out. You're going to have to put some action in that word. You're going to have to search yourself out to see God's word manifest in your life. And even maybe what God will instruct you to do, it might be tough. It might be a little bit difficult to swallow, but if you can get to God, one of my sisters says today, and she's on the line tonight, Pastor Pat Jones out of Jacksonville, Florida, she said today, if we're going to get this next move of God, it's going to cost us everything, but are we willing to go? Are you willing to give what it takes to get this next move of God? And I am. I don't know about you, but I am willing to get that. For a fact, I believe that you all are willing to do whatever it takes to get to God. And let me just open up today. We basically post the prophetic forecast that God gave us for 2012. And anybody who follow our ministry, God releases a word every year. And I'm telling you, my church, they go line by line and chart those words and track them. And we have seen God year after year after year, everything that he declared out of our mouth for those things to come to pass. This year was real unique because God started talking to me about 2012 back in October. And first thing he told me was the church was in a season of splendor. I said, God, this is really unique that the church would be in a season of splendor when it looks like the church is going backwards. And many of believers and pastors and leaders, they're just tired. They're worn out. It seems like they're doing it by themselves. The people are fainting. The people are being leery and weary. For fact, folk are not just leaving, but they're leaving throwing rocks. the people that you feed and that you clothe and you pay their bills and you struggle with them and suffer with them, but they leave and kill your name. And God would speak in that season that the church was in a moment of splendor. At that point, you didn't get the complete understanding, because we prophesy in part and we know in part, and it is for us to seek God for the additional parts. And many times, my pastor and I was talking, what we don't realize is that you may not get the other part, but God will put you in connection with prophetic people who can know the other parts and hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying for that season, so that you can get clear understanding. And God had given me a specific word, and I had been basically pinning those words down and trying to just chart them and track them and make sure that I didn't miss him in this season. But one of the things that I wanted to tell you tonight before we go directly into the Word of the Lord was that this is just a piece of it, and you can go to our Facebook page. I'm sure there's a link there where you can get the entire message so that you can hear it. And it's important that you hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying, because he spoke to us about North Korea, he spoke to us about the weather, he spoke to us about the government, and there's some specific things he said for kingdom government. So I think you need to understand what God is saying and what he's releasing in this hour. But I wanted to share with you, before we go in the Word, a part of the prophetic forecast for 2012. One of the things God told me a few weeks ago, that we are in a spiritual tilt. And basically, the earth rotates on its axis. And what happens is, as seasons change, there's four natural seasons. There's also four spiritual seasons. And as seasons change, it is the sign that you are either directly connected to the sun or you are on the opposite side of the sun. So when winter, when the earth has rotated to winter, that is a sign that we are as furthest from the sun. But during the summertime, that's the sign you're the closest to the sun. And I'm talking about S-U-N sun, the one that gives the ray of light. But God began to speak to me, and he said, the same is true in the spirit. He said, I want my children to understand that there are four cycles. There's every year, every spiritual year, there are four major cycles that takes place. Now, according, it's not like winter, spring, summer, fall. He didn't tell me specifically how those cycles takes place. See, that's how we go get the additional part. But God said, during those cycles, three things happen. During these season change, cycle shows back up, and three things happen. He said, you either go back into old cycles, you either jump into what he's releasing, the next assignment leading to the next destiny, you're in purpose, or either you're going to be deceived. And what kind of jarred this, one morning I was watching Oprah Winfrey on TV, talking to an interview and some gentleman on there. This has been recently. This is not on her show, but this is on her network, so this is recent. And Oprah was sitting there telling the man, and they were talking about different religions, and they were talking about different gods. And they, one thing specifically I heard her say, her and the gentleman, they basically begin to say that art is prayer. Now, I didn't say they said art was a form of prayer, but they said art was prayer. So they said you didn't need to make a petition to a God, that if you could get up there and paint, you know, they were saying that that is prayer, and that creativity is prayer. And the Spirit of God jarred me. He said, I told you during a season change, or when the earth is on a tilt, that's one of the things that would happen, is deception will show up in the greatest form, because people are broken and they're open and they're looking for something. And let me say to you, I know that many of us have been waiting on God, we're believing God, but whatever you do, don't faint now. Don't quit now. Don't throw in the towel now. Don't get deceived now. Don't go left now. And even if you've been doing things that's contrary to the word of the Lord, my declaration to you is repent, for the kingdom is at hand. Just get yourself back to God. Get in right standing with God. Call on him while he may be found, so that you can seek his face and get what he's trying to release in this hour, because deception is in the land. And if it's released in the earth like that, then it would have had to produce itself first in the church. And so they were telling people over a network where millions of people was listening that art is prayer, and that your creativity is prayer. But let me say to you, art is not prayer. Art is not Jesus. It's not Father. You cannot get to the Father through art. Art may be an expression that God used, but that is the deception that is being released in the cycle. Now, when you understand the tilt, that has to happen because God now has allowed the wheat and the tare to grow together, and now he's separating. And so God will allow these different cycles so that you can see exactly what's inside people in this season. And so I'm telling you, God is moving by his power.